My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon. Last time I played this was a few days ago. I've given myself some time to desalinate and untilt myself, but of course we will still be playing the Marine. Oh god, the echoes in this room are completely different now. Oh boy. I'll explain why the difference as we move into the game. 17! 17 shambling realms! Still! Jerry, there's 17! I know! 17! Sorry. once you get to a certain level of pitch, you just have to Seinfeld it up, right? That's all you can do. Even if you can't do a good Seinfeld impersonation, you have to at that limit. Alright, so what's happening with the reverberations and the echo in the room? I don't know if you'll be able to hear much of the actual difference that's occurring here, but I can definitely hear it. So I wonder if possibly it's making its way through the microphone and into the recording. Basically, what's occurring here is I've had my windows soundproofed. I live near to some very, very busy areas, and as a result, my windows have been soundproofed. But the odd unintended side effect is that, sure, no noise is getting into my room, but no noise is getting out, so I can actually hear my own voice a lot more in a way that I'm not entirely okay with, but also not entirely displeased by. Let's be honest, if I didn't like the sound of my own voice, I probably wouldn't record 3 to 4 hours of it each day. And then add streams on top of that, so sometimes up to 8. So... So I can't exactly defend myself by saying, no, well, you know, it's the hazard of what I do. It's part of the attraction for what I do, apparently. All right, blow these guys up from afar. Excellent. No, friend. Good lord. Can't even use the traps in the room. I'm going to keep a running total. A running total, rather than not an actual count. So not like a tally or a running total, as I said. But more like a figure in my mind of what I think about the actual reverberations in the room, because at the moment I'm kind of enjoying it because it's letting me mediate my voice in an interesting way. If you watched any of the early Hearthstone Arena episodes, and I say early, but they would have been in the hundreds, there was a point at which I plugged in a second set of headphones so that I could listen to the feedback coming from my microphone system, so that I could pretty much, like, learn to use my voice better. Because I wanted to know, okay, right, how do I sound when I'm controlling my voice in this way, and in this way, and in this way, so that I could basically get some better vocal control. I feel like that helped me, but I also feel like I don't need to do it anymore. And yet, here I am. I can so clearly hear my own voice as well. Usually when I'm recording these episodes, I hear, you know, what appears to me, as my own voice. You'll all be familiar with this concept if you've ever heard yourself recorded in any way, shape, or form. The huge disparity between what you think you sound like and what you actually sound like. Now, I'm very, very familiar with that disparity, as you might imagine. I've heard very many hours of my own voice. But still, I hear my voice entirely differently to how I hear it on tape. I haven't managed to move into a frame of mind where I go, yeah, this is what I'm hearing, but I know it's like this. I'm still fooled by the illusion every single time. However, at the moment, I can hear my voice as it would actually appear. It's more than a little jarring, which is why I'm spending 5 billion years talking about it at the start of the episode. Let's just talk about all the mad money we're making, Jim Cramer style. 100% ripped off joke right there. All right, we've got 65 credits, or rather casings, for a HP up in the store. I am 100% all about that shit right there. Right there, right there. So what I'm going to want to do is get a key to drop, because I can't afford to buy the key and the heart container. At this point, it's looking like I might not even be able to afford the heart container. Consider that it's very likely, excuse me, Thank you. Consider it's very likely for me to get around maybe 10 on the high side from the boss. If I sold an item, like a blue chest item, anything that's entirely useless, I might actually make my way there. Chlorinthia is not useless though. Chlorinthia is so good. Oh, it's just the passive of the millennia. All right, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna fight the boss with my base weapon. I usually don't like doing this. Okay, thankfully it's you. I can fight you with my base weapon. That's not too bad. Especially with all these extra blanks. Because if the boss gives me a key and some money, and especially if he gives me an item that is relatively high tier, like, you know, blue or green, just not brown, basically. If he gives me an item that is relatively high tier that I don't want, dude, I'll just sell it and then I'll get myself the HP up. The HP up is so much more important than it seems. Excuse me. Speaking of HP up being more important than it seems, almost lost mine there from the loss of the flawless. Okay. Pretty much any enemy except for the bullet twins, I was going to be able to have a good shot at. Nope, that's going to need a blank. Have a good shot at possibly flawlessing with my base pistol. I say possibly. I should be at the point in my Gungeon career where I am able to flawless the first floor boss with every single different starting pistol, no matter what class and no matter what starting pistol. That said, you give me the pilot starting pistol and the trigger twins and I'm going to cry. Hegemony carbine is okay. Damn it, I was really hoping. Okay. You know what? I should have checked the other two rooms before I did the blank. Possibly the secret room would have bailed me out of this. I think I sell my ammo up. But if I sell my ammo up, I'll get, what, 15 in response? So I'll be able to get the HP, but I won't be able to get the key. If I sell a blue tier, then I'm not guaranteed to have a weapon, really. You know what? I'm doing it. Bad decisions already made. Can't take it back. I have forgotten, evidently, how much money I was going to get, so now I also have to sell that. Good work, Ryan. You gosh dang dullard. Thankfully, we have a sell grade, so we can do stuff like this. Basically, I put myself in a defensive powerhouse position. I've got 2 HP up from the first floor. That is just god dang amazing. And then on top of that, I've also got dodge up. You know what? 100% okay with this. That is the Tangler. The Tangler is a very, very good boss clear for, you know, first and second floor, and a completely fine room clear for every other floor of the game, especially if you get some accuracy up. Ooh, what's this? What is this game? I'm not going to mention what it is until I decide whether or not I am interested in it. Nope. Never mind. Sorry, I just got another email. I don't know why I have my phone so nearby. Oh, right, that's right, because the room was being worked on, so the only point where I can charge my phone is directly next to my computer. Got it. Good work, Ryan. Get away from me. Nice. Basically, what happened is I saw an email from a developer saying, hey, Steam key for a review or let's play of this game. And it's a RPG Maker game. Nothing against RPG Maker games. I'm sure there are great RPG Maker games. It's just not my thing. Just not my thing. Whee! Okay, take all y'all out. Beautiful. Kind of wanted a second wave to spawn there so that I could actually... Oh, get him! No! That wasn't get him. That was anti-get him. That was got me. Dang it. All right, shambling around in the middle of the map after I complete. Come on. Come on, I need a good shambling round. Oh, baby, it's so good. The accuracy up is real. I wouldn't expect to hit all of those at that range. And then I remembered what character, excuse me, that I'm playing as. The Marine. I have Marine training by base. Which is why my shots are hitting in a lot of circumstances where I ought not think they could. Oh, yo, what about accuracy up, by the way? Scope over there. If I end up getting another shotgun type weapon this floor, I'm actually probably really well served by selling possibly even my Chloranthi ring. I know I was talking it up before, but possibly even selling that. Looks like I might get enough money in order to afford the scope. Simply because all of that accuracy up on a shotgun. Potion seller. I'm going into battle. And I have need of only your... Oh, baby. Very nice. Unfortunately, this is not his strongest potion. Okay, we'll see. Green chest is the highest tier we get. Nice. I suspected that might occur. Did strongly suspect that. Now, how could we have optimized our play so far? The biggest way for us to have optimized our play so far would be to have found the secret room last floor before I sold the hegemony carbine. Because it sells for the same whether or not it's full of ammunition. So I may as well have just actually used it to definitely find the secret room that possibly exists on that floor. Again, secret rooms don't always exist. But it's entirely possible that a secret room existed on that floor and could have given me a crummy item for free that I then could have sold instead of the hegemony carbine or instead of my ammunition. Okay, very nicely done. What I'd like now, and this weirdly ties into, excuse me, the fact that I lost that ammunition, is I kind of want damage up. I always want damage up, right? But I kind of want damage up very specifically right now because it will help me deal with having less ammunition because I can use my base pistol for longer. Okay, I've not picked up a gun from this floor yet. So I'm actually going to fight the boss so that I can guarantee that the boss will give me a gun. If you've not picked up a gun yet on that floor, the boss is guaranteed to drop a gun for you, by the way. That's the science behind that. Okay. Load. Stagger my steps. Okay, we ought to be... pretty well settled on the issue of the people v. the Beholster.
Guilty, 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 guilty!
Take that and that and that and... oh, baby, a smorgasbord for me? Don't mind if I do. The Rubidine is actually quite inaccurate. Like, hang on. What's a good example of this? If this was perfectly accurate, this should come straight back at me. Alright, bad example. Oh, yo, that's actually really good. Both of my weapons bounce off walls. So having backup shot is actually going to end up with more bullets. Yeah, it's actually quite good. Quite good in this scenario. I don't want either of those. I do want the accuracy up, though. So sue me. Maybe I didn't need it, but I'm taking it anyway. So sue me. Don't sue me. Seriously, please. Have mercy. Okay. Backup gun is best used with weapons that have auto-aim, though. I literally do not need any more accuracy up. At this point, any more accuracy up will actually... just not give us any benefit. It will not confer any benefit whatsoever. Unless, of course, I get a super inaccurate gun. For the guns that I currently have, I ought to say, it won't really give me much benefit whatsoever. I've always wondered one thing about this game, and that's that some websites talk about guns giving you weapon spread down, and some talk about them giving you accuracy up. I wonder if those two are the exact same statistic, or if they're slightly different in the same way that in Isaac there are things like, you know, tier delay down and tier rate up. Two completely different things that have similar consequences, but different mechanical governings behind them. So they actually can be abused individually. Sure. Can I sell this? I think there was a sell grade, actually. No, there wasn't. Okay, never mind. I'm dumb. Well, let's get out of here. No reason not to just blank the exit on the way out. I can easily use the mailbox for my clears next floor. From room to room. Plus, mailbox, big problem, usually inaccurate. Not so much of a problem anymore now, is it? Rhetorical question. It isn't, by the way. Just in case you need an answer for the rhetorical question. The Black Powder Mine. Nice. I kind of want the clip size to be smaller for this weapon. I know there's a synergy for one weapon. It's not the Zor gun. What weapon is it again? Oh, I think it might be the Eye of the Beholster, where there's a synergy for that weapon that actually decreases its clip size so that you can fire the special clip, the special round at the end of each clip more often. That's so cool of an idea. Hey, that's pretty good. Take him down. Take him downtown, boys. Mark him down. I can't remember the Hawaii Five-O theme for the life of me. But if I could, I'd do it right now. Oh, don't get me wrong. I'm not a fan of the classics. I was about to say flan of the classics. That's right. I'm not a particularly puffy... It's not a pastry. It's more of a gelatinous-ish dessert. I'm not a fan of the classics. In this scenario, at least. I only know of the Hawaii Five-O remake. With... the guy who played Jin? From Lost? And I know literally none of the actors or actresses in it at all. I know the guy who played Jin from Lost. And he would probably be... a little mad not to be referred to by his first name, but look, everyone else doesn't even get that. They don't even get an accreditation from their IMDb page. Beautiful. I've watched like 4 or 5 seasons of that. I really ought to know. Okay, maybe closer to 3 seasons. Because I don't know if they ended up making 4 or 5 seasons. But I really ought to know the names of some of the actors and actresses in it. You'd think just by osmosis. I would have watched the credit sequence enough times to accidentally remember the name of even one person involved. Nope. Not a clue. Sorry, friends. I tried. Ooh, I like this room. And we have a special room on the lower side. Nice. So I like this room because all of your enemies poison themselves by trying to come and get to you. It means they kill themselves. It's really cool. See? I only actually had to kill one of the enemies there. I see you, baby. Shaking that brass. All right, Gun Muncher, we'll see what we want to do with you. What up? What up, Space Friend? Wingman, never mind. I knew it wasn't Space Friend. Space Friend's green tier, and Space Friend also... What is Space Friend also? Space Friend is unlocked from the Hegemony credit store, whereas Wingman is your bonus from completing the Pilot's Past, or rather one of your bonuses from completing the Pilot's Past. I know the difference between the items. I just say the wrong thing all the time. It's kind of like there's a dish that Pete cooks particularly often that I really enjoy. And the only way that I can ever identify it to him is by saying, can we have the thing that I don't know whether it's curry or satay? That is the only description I can give. Because every single time we have it, I call it the wrong thing, or the wrong thing is mentioned at some point during that day, and the only way I can refer to it is by knowing that I can't refer to it. It's indescribable. Quite literally. Whee! Get him! Nice. Let's get back to the shop. Let's head back in that direction so that I can get my key on. So Wingman's really good, by the way, it turns out. Wingman is quite good. Fires missiles, he's a pretty good dude in general. Blocks tears as well. Didn't know that about you, friend. Okay, I probably could have guessed. A lot of them do. Enraging Photo, not really my kind of thing. Thanks, but no thanks. If only we still needed Gunzookies, because this is, like, perfect for that run. We fought maybe four already this floor. Whee! Not even mentioning the ones we've got here. Oh, okay! As soon as we visit the shop, the keys start dropping. I like it. I like it. I'm also actually really enjoying using this weapon with the accuracy up. I know for a fact that I would hate with using it with accuracy down, or no accuracy, or whatever. It's just not actually a good weapon. Okay, and guess we're off to the boss then. But with accuracy up, it's fine. We still don't really have a boss weapon. I'm probably going to use Rubidine and the Tangler. Especially depending on the boss. Rubidine is most likely going to be my solo clear if it's the tank. So I may as well just put both of them on. Okay. Okay, that was really close. Ryan, stop playing so fast and fancy free right now. We just need some good old, no-frills victory. Okay, can you handle that, friend? Can ya? Cause it doesn't look like you can right now. That said, this guy is being very friendly with his attacks right now. Good RNG. I like that the developers made it so that if he bounces off two walls within a certain time frame of one another, he can't cause the bounce off both of the walls. Because that would suck. Nope, get back here. No, come on! This is lame as hell. There is no need for this, friend. Get back here. Got him. We should have killed him before he went through that. Skull Splitter will kill the boss next floor, but it'll kill like half of their HP. We don't have bad enough weapons to throw away. Mailbox is almost out of ammo though. Look, I can throw two browns in. Because Plague Pistol does zero damage, and we're almost out of ammunition on the mailbox, and I'm not going to refill its ammunition. Not again. So we could end up with sling or regular shotgun and be really happy. Or we could end up with anything else and be quite... Oh, you know what? With accuracy up, that's actually not a bad gun. The huge problem with this gun is its super lame accuracy. You can see, I have two accuracies up. And it is still really dodgy. But that's the big limiting factor on this. It's got penetrative, and it is immediate. I mean, it's a laser. What do you want? Especially with Space Friend here to help us out in terms of damage, this could actually end up being quite good. It's always good to have Space Friend just because I don't have to supply all of the damage. Pretty much all of my low damage weapons have a static DPS boost as a result of this guy. Okay, where are you, friend? Hey, there you are. Get him. Nice. Nice catch, Space Friend. Okay, you're down here doing your shenanigans. The big problem that I'm actually encountering with using this weapon so far is the amount of light it's casting on the screen. No! I slid upon the ice. The amount of light that's casting on the screen is actually really confusing my senses. Especially because I've got backup gun hitting behind me as well. So I can't tell where I'm hitting at all times. I can't tell where the opponent's bullets are at all times. I can't tell where the opponents are. And that's probably the key flaw in this entire thing. In a bullet hell game, typically you need to know where, at the very least, the opponents are, if not also the bullets. Oh well. Ooh! A shrine that is locked. God, if that's an ammo shrine, I'm gonna be annoyed about it, but then I'll use it and I'll be happy about it. Ammo shrine refills the ammo of all of your weapons for the simple cost of 3.5 curse. Which, if you're taking curse in your run, is a huge amount of curse. If you're not taking curse in your run, not really a problem. This is also a special room. Please don't be just a gun muncher. Fuck. Wish it were a gun muncher. You know what? Screw it. No! That's the worst it could have been! I wasted two keys right there. Neither of those rooms will amount to anything. Unless we go back to the blank shop, and the blank shop has a... One second. No! I saw that happening. The guy was behind me. I couldn't see him behind me because I kept casting light behind myself. Unless you have the secret room on the other side of you. Don't worry, he won't get mad at me for accidentally shooting him.
Benedict's bullet.
Alright, we're about to run out of ammunition on this weapon as well, so we'll probably have to swap over to the Tangle. He'll come for me sooner or later. Yup. Could have told you that shit was gonna happen. In fact, I did! I did tell you that shit was gonna happen. Alright, let's get ready on our next weapon. Oh, if there's one thing I love about this weapon, and there is one thing I love about this weapon, it's that those red conjury bastards can't take your bullets. Cause it's photons. How are you gonna take the photons, friend? Exactly, that's what I thought. Hell, it's a bit of a shame that actually doesn't turn out to be a mimic, because I could really use with some free chest right now. Okay. Oh, thank you. That's really important. If the shop is locked, I'm going to cry. Oh, come on. As far as I'm concerned, we dodged that. Let's just agree that I dodged that and ignore the fact that I took damage there. Okay. There we go. That's what I wanted. And then as long as I take you out, your friend will come out to fight me. What up, buddy? Didn't think you were gonna get a face full of buckshot when you came out of there, did you? Excellent. I'm definitely on the right side of this entire room as well. Because this room can be a right hassle when you walk in on the other side. Some rooms in this game are more difficult depending on how you walk into them. This is a prime example. If you walk in from the right side, that second spawn, the two red blobs, they cut you off from moving into the rest of the map, and you have to recede into one of these hidey holes, in which case you are definitely going to take damage. Unless you blank the way out of there. So, of course, you just need to not recede into one of those. You need to do some fancy footwork. Video game, please. Need to do some fancy footwork so that doesn't occur to you. Okay, I actually still haven't even tested you. Nice. Two green chests. If my shop is locked, I repeat, I will cry. It's locked. Woe is me. Never said I was gonna, like, actually cry. I totally did, didn't I? Well, look, I can't get into that shop without opening a locked door. So we had a locked shop, locked special shop, and locked shrine room. Do you know how unlucky that is? I've been hoarding keys this whole run. Every opportunity, I've bought them. And I'm still running short as a result of that shit. Wow. Now that's what I call getting fucked around. Good thing we got an extra HP up, because we are not gonna flawless this boss. Tell you that much right now. Yep, there's the hit.
There's the hit to ruin the day. And Mighty Mouse is on his way.
Ah, beautiful. No! No! Yep, there's a second hit. You know, it's like one in every 20 fights that he will actually come down into that corridor and try and hit you. No! What? He ran into me! You know what? I'm glad I've taken so much bullshit damage this fight. Makes me feel less bad about all of the rest of the bullshit damage I've taken against this guy. I don't like him. I think he's really bad. No. All right, down here. I guarantee you. Yep. Guarantee you. I didn't even have time to give you the guarantee. That's how much I could have guaranteed you that was going to happen. If we actually had a boss weapon, especially something explosive, that maybe would have destroyed your bullets. Thank you. That was a good roll, actually, on my part. Despite all of the damage I've taken here, I still feel like this has been a relatively good fight against this guy, especially considering the weaponry. Oh, we got a key. Nice. I actually really appreciate that game. Hey, Beehive is really, really good. Thank you. Thank you, video game. Can show some appreciation. Alright, fuck off, video game. Who needs you? What is that? This isn't gonna turn into last run where you give me every bad every bad green chest item that ever existed, and then I gun munch them and you give them back. That's not gonna happen to me, is it? Because if it does, I retire. You know what? Sure. I don't even have one yet, so sure.
Sure, mate. I'll take that off your hands. Alright, Governor.
Alright, that's not the accent I was going for. I was trying to go for more gruff Aussie worker. And I ended up with Cockney. I don't even know if that's Cockney. I just know that Cockney is an accent in Britain, and that that is something that I've heard from shoeshiners in musicals. All right. I guess we're on that Void Call Assault Rifle bender. Okay, I at least enjoy the accuracy of this gun. Not always the most accurate thing, and yet, it currently is. Oh, screw you! I hate that attack so much. And he did it instantly. It's so rare they do that attack, and he did it instantly. What is this? Poop on Ryan Day? Stop it. I need to live. All right, YV. All right, YV. We'll see how much money we can collect for you and how much I have to use for reconstructive surgery to try and keep myself alive here. The reconstructive surgery is, like, medically valid. It's not aesthetic or cosmetic. I'm just looking for someone to glue my ass back onto my body after the game rips it off. Okay. Hate that it's 6, 9... 12. I have to use 12 to kill a gelatinous cube. That's a significant portion of the amount of ammo I even have. Yep, alright, and now we're off to... Crud. Okay, look, I have to refill this weapon anyway. I have to refill this weapon anyway, so we can use it, but I need weapons to kill the boss with, so I guess I'm on pistol duty at the moment. I'm a pistol packing mama. So obviously I can't use YV yet, because if there is ammunition in the shop, I need that. Thank you for making my life easy on this instance. I can't even test for secret rooms right now. I am so po. Alright. Oh no. No. Okay, beautiful. We're down to just you. Thank you. I thought we were down to just you. Now we're down to just you and the next wave. Come on, space friend. I need you to help me out here. Because the game clearly isn't looking to. Excuse me. Thank you for the predictive shot, video game. It was very kind and appreciated. We got a bunch of HP, but we're losing all of it. Because we still don't have the ability to, I don't know, efficiently clear rooms. But moreover than that, kill bosses? Like, we do have a bunch of what would be okay room clear weapons. I'm actually going to refill the Tangler here. We do have a bunch of okay room clear weapons. But we have to waste all the ammunition fighting bosses. So, what that results in is us not having any okay room clear weapons. Alright. I'll take a key so that if I go into a chest room by accident, I can still open it if it has a fuse on it. The fuse should be really unlikely, though. Nice. Very, very nice. Anyone else? Yes, there's another wave. It's more than okay if we can insta-jib them. Look, insta might be a little quick. But jib them we did. Bouncy bullets. I need the ammo. We'll see. So bouncy bullets will make my bullet bouncing off the wall behind me, my backup gun, that is, way better. It'll make that work with every single gun. That said, do I care? Not all my guns can take advantage of that. All right, we can kill you right now, hopefully. So thanks to backup gun, we basically just fire twice as many bees here. Pretty good synergy. Whee! Look at all them bees! I was hoping that I wouldn't have to blank there. Because there are worse things that are going to occur in this fight that I'm going to need to blank. And I'd prefer to have the blanks left for when I need them rather than use them when I don't. Okay, Skull Spitter, unfortunately, is pretty directional. Okay, nice. Very, very nice. With the Chloranthi Ring, we should not have too much difficulty dodging through these. We're actually probably best served by using the Tangler here. Chloranthi Ring is dodge power up, so we... My understanding is that you have more invincibility frames in your dodges. So, we ought to be able to flawless here. And that's going to be quite important. If I wanted to be tricky, I would have tried to roll through the four in a row on the previous hit. But I'm not that confident in myself. Okay. We can roll through three without any dodge power up, so that's good news for us. There's so much stuff on the screen right now. This is not okay. We're done. Nice. That was good flawless. So we missed the fourth floor flawless, and that's it. Alright, I'll take it. I'll take it. Whew! It's a bunch of credits right there. So, 150. In a pop-up shrine, 150 is 5 charges, right? 10? 20, 30, 40, and 50. Because 10, 20, 30, 40 makes up a total of 100, and then 50 makes up 150. So yeah, you get 5 charges. So 20% of our bullets would replicate themselves. That's interesting. But maybe bouncy bullets is probably not on the menu. What might be, ooh, I'm glad I opened that first. What might be on the menu is ammunition. Because there was ammunition available in the shop as well. That might flip my mind on it. That might change my mind. Because neither of these weapons have ammunition. They're worth less than they would be. And the beehive, it's fine, but only against bosses. It's a really good synergy, but the amount of damage per second you have or can do is limited. So for a full AK-47, yeah, no, I'm okay with that as a trade. Okay. thank you for keeping me safe, portable turret. Good gosh. Good golly gosh if you did not do your job right there. Damn. Some serious work. Haha! You're funny, video game. You're hilarious. I'm laughing. I'm dying over here. Oh, just listen to me laugh. Here we go. Huh. That's all the laughing I can put out at the moment, buddy. Fuck off. I actually did that. I was like, yeah, okay, no, this will be fine. Backup gone. More keys. More keys, sure. More keys. Yeah. Yep. No, that's a thing that should happen to me. That's a thing that should happen. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm not going to be able to get the final one. I can probably only afford armor right now. Because, yeah, ammo's just a little out of my pay grade right now. Sure. Well, this is going to be interesting. Interesting in the, how is this gonna work kind of way? Because that would have been our green chest weapon. And I shot it. I shot it real bad. I knew I should have opened it first as well, but I was like, secret room. I was even thinking, don't shoot the chest. Don't shoot the chest. Backup gun? Never mind. Turns out I shot the chest. I shot the secret, but I did not shoot the chest, you see. Fuck this room! No! Get away from me! Got him. No! It's not- get away! Thank you. Well, off to a crash hot start, I think you can tell. Hey, you know what? It does look like we might be going in the right direction at least. So, there's that. And since my shotgun shoots, you know, 4 or 5 bullets every single shot, it's actually getting pop almost every single time I shoot. That's pretty good. Hey, that's pretty good. Okay. Nope. Get him. Thank you. The duplications are actually a very, very significant increase in my damage. Okay, it looks like the easiest way around was around and across, but how was I to know that? Thank you. Safest place I can be right now. Got him. Excuse me? I don't know about that damage. I don't know about that one, friend. Excuse me? Good lord. Okay, we're fine. We're fine now. Wait for them all to take their shots. No! Missed! Missed! And I don't know if I can afford to. Oh! That's pretty good. So that's the dungeon map. We can see everything now. so we can avoid the pitfalls of the rest of the floor. That is going to save us a bunch of HP and ammunition. Thank you very much, video game. A black chest appearing after I complete a room. That's also very unlikely. Thank you very much, video game. Giving me something that's actually relevant to my run and quite good. Thank you very much, video game. We're still going to need a lot of HP and ammo. Thank you very much, video game. Because even if we find the secret room, right? And I know where it is. It's up. Right, it's just all the way back up. Even if we go to the secret room, what am I going to give it? Excuse me? Thank you. I've been to that secret room a bunch recently, and I've given it some really good stuff. And it has not repaid me in any way, shape, or form. I have not gotten the requisite value from that to consider it worth my time. Okay. Nice. Get him. And you too. If I can just make my way to the boss room really quick, maybe I can pretend that I didn't take all this damage, and the boss will agree. I still feel like I made a horrible mistake in dropping the beehive. The AK-47 is good. But it's not good enough. I feel like I was a little too zealous in making the decision that, hey, I need to definitely take advantage of this. And then immediately leaping aboard. Rather than taking my time and figuring out exactly what I wanted to do about it. Obviously, shooting the green chest as well is stupid as flip. Because it could have given me a really bad green chest gun, and then I would have thrown that in. Oh, come on! He spawned in the taking animation. Took all of my bullets and immediately threw them back. Didn't even wait to finish his animation. That's not okay. Surely. If we can persevere? What's the word I'm looking for? Preserve, that's right. If we can preserve this amount of HP until the final fight, we might have a chance. Not a good one. Don't get me wrong, buddy. Not a good one. But a chance. Which is better than I could have hoped for a lot of this so far. At least die against the Lich, Ryan. No! Got him. Oh, okay. Looks like we're off to die against the Lich. This is gonna be fun. We will keep the Skull Splitter on the offside, just in case the Lich does summons. Don't do summons as your foot. Thank you. The dodges are real right now, though. I don't know if you noticed that, but the dodges, they were kind of real right there. Ah, you slimy bastard. Okay. Okay, keep it. Keep on firing. And that's a flawless first phase. That was pretty good. Now, I know I can't flawless the second phase, so I'll be utilizing a lot of my blanks there. Because the third phase, I'm actually better at dodging the attacks off. Unless, you know, there's the obviously blatantly difficult attacks. Blatantly unfair attacks, I guess. This guy also has blatantly unfair attacks, but he does them way more often than the next phase. Is one of your unfair attacks doing those two at the same time as one another? Awesome. Glad you opened the fight like that. Really good trendsetter right there. Oh, don't you dare. I'm dead. Yep. I knew it as well. I knew it. So I was gonna abuse blanks in this fight when the wiggly ones came out. Didn't have the ability to. If I took any more HP into that final fight, we would have been pretty well set up for the win. Not having a boss weapon really hurt us, though. Like, the Tangler was our best boss weapon. It worked really well there in the end, but only by virtue of the fact that we had so much accuracy that a shotgun was pretty good in the end of the game. And also due to the fact that we had the YV Shrine. Any actual boss weapon would have made so much more work of that pretty much earlier. Oh well, I feel a lot better about that run than a lot of the runs prior at the very least, so I'll count that, despite not winning, as relatively desalinating. My name has been Rhapsody, the name of the game has been holy shit, we're over 100 hegemony credits, hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we will see you next time.